So from this weekend, we will allow single adult households to form a support bubble with one other household.
A bubble? A bubble with all my friends in it? Yeah, defo. Wendy, did you see it? About the bubbles. You being mine, and if Jackie's in yours, how many people can you have, just max? I don't want Falula in it, Jackie's sister. Not since the hen do. Because she had me arrested for dancing naked in front of the mayor. Oh, it's complicated this, isn't it? Well, shall I draw a map of it and I'll bring it round in a bit? Who do you want? No, definitely not. Definitely not. Jessie G, she's banned. This is dead exciting, this bubble business. How's everyone else planning their bubbles? Keisha's love, it's Holly. Have you done your bubble yet? Yeah, I've put you in mine. You put me in yours? Why not? Don't be tight, Keisha's. Jackie. Hey, Jackie. It's me, Holly. No, I've not put Falula in it. And I'll put Maureen in. I'll put Maureen in because Maureen's got a new line of DVDs coming in. She reckons she's got all of CSI Miami now. Oh God, this is absolutely hectic. I'd like to speak to Beverly Callard, please. It's Holly Stars. It's Holly Stars. Why won't she? No, because that restraining order is only for in person. Work experience, girl. Because someone's got to clean this bubble. Work experience girl, it's Holly. It's not your day off, you know, work experience girls don't get a day off. She doesn't mind if you come over, she won't mind. If she's in intensive care, she won't even know if you've come over. Oh, Gary, for when he gets out, Gary, for next. But I'll put him in brackets because he's next week. But I'm thinking actually for this week, maybe I should invite Ross Kemp over. But, you know, keep me busy before Gary gets out. This is hard work, the cyber at school. Oh, I need a lozenge. I'll need a honey and lemon locket after that pint. McCutcheon. I'll put Micah from the Bake Off in. She's got a nice temple. Put Leona Lewis in because she could sing that song when she comes to the Brewer's Arms next. She does it on a karaoke. Keep bleeding, keep bleeding. What do you want? Oh, hi. Oh, hello. Yes, I did leave a message for Beverly Callard. This isn't fair, this. Just because you're a resistant doesn't mean you can be constantly fobbing me off. No, don't call the police again. Don't do that. What are you being tight for? It's supposed to be a nice thing as pointer in my bubble. Oh my God. Don't ruin this for me. You are being so tight on me. Just invite her to me barbecue so she can be in me bubble. Fine, but I'll find out who you are, and I will.
Bye then.
Hello, I'm back. Woo! Holly stars, everyone. What an incredible performance. I know that she was jiggling into her creative mind in order to give us that one, and I'm so glad we got to see a bit of that Boris Johnson too. Now, the next performance we've got is a voice. He's a voice indeed. He's been in Rent. Everyone's talking about Jamie. Numerous professional musicals in the West End. And he's here for us, HV Scotland. Remember the ways to donate? We'll be giving you an update on how much we've raised in the next 10 minutes. But for now, this one is Leighton Williams.
Hey y'all, it's Leighton Williams here. I hope you're keeping well and safe. I've come to sing you a song from Rent. I played Angel once upon a time. It taught me a lot and it was an absolute pleasure to play such an iconic LGBTQ plus role. So I hope you enjoy. This is a love song. It is a duet, so I'm gonna be singing it by myself. So please feel free to sing along if you want. Be my Collins to my Angel. And yeah, sending you lots of love.
Just pay me back with 1,000 kisses. Be my lover, and I'll cover you. Open your door, sing. I'll be your tenant. Don't got much baggage to lay at your feet. For sweet kisses, I've got to spare. I'll be there, and I'll cover you. I think they meant it when they said you can't buy love. Now I know you can't rent it and release you of my love. Alive, be my life. Just lay me on, I'll be your blessing.
Give it up for the wonderful Leighton Williams. Thank you so much, Leighton, for being part of HV Scotland Live in Lockdown 2. And he was indeed part of Live in Lockdown 1 as well. And this next queen has been part of Live in Lockdown. She has been raising money for HV Scotland. She is a legend. Some would call her the Queen of Scotland, but I won't give her that title while I'm wearing this tartan. She is RuPaul Drag Race legend. She's been on All Stars. She is representing Scotland with her American accent all over the States. Please put your hands together for the one and only Morgan McMichaels.
Today, listen. so good to me, I know, but I can't change. Tried to tell you, but you look at me like maybe I'm an angel underneath, innocent and sweet.
I've seen enough. It's absolutely ridiculous. I mean, me, kids, I'm taking over. Taking over. I have cancelled all your appointments, and for the next week, you're going to play by my rules. And at the end of the week, some of you may still be working here, and some of you may not.
Yesterday I cried, must have been relieved to see the softer side. I can understand how you'd be so confused. I don't envy you, I'm a little bit of everything. I'll roll into one, I'm a bitch, I'm a lover, I'm a child, I'm a mother, I'm a sinner, I'm a saint. I do not feel ashamed, I'm your help, I'm your dreamer, I'm nothing in between, you know you wouldn't want it any other way.
That's dirty, what's all of that? That's totally ruined. It just looks run down. Nothing looks fresh in here. What's going on with this? I mean, it's like a murder victim, honestly. Wow. We have a problem. Oh, and this is nice. You know, that is absolutely disgusting. I swear to God. And this place has to be scrubbed down because it is ridiculous. I've never been in a salon that makes me want to throw up.
Yes.
I gotta go because I will throw up.
Yeah. So take me as I am. This may mean you'll have to be a stronger man. Rest assured that when I start to make you nervous and I'm going to extremes, tomorrow I will change and today won't be the thing. I'm a bitch. I'm a lover. I'm a child.
Business, you have to be there to run it. It is not heavenly in here, and you seem to think it's quite amusing and funny. I would be embarrassed to have a client come in here, mortified. Never seen anything so unprofessional in my life. You're talking about a heavenly experience? What about this? This is disgusting. This has to be the most ghetto, unprofessional thing I have seen in 26 years. Embarrassing. And everyone's looking at me like it's the funniest thing they've ever seen. It's funny to me that it is so bad. I'm assuming that clients sit under here, do they? Look at that. Is this all from today? I don't think so, because these are moldy. This is mold. Don't try and sell it to me. This is more than a problem. This is hygienic, let me tell you. It is one of the filthiest salons I've ever seen. This salon is absolutely revolting. You are kidding me, right? You have to be absolutely off your rocker. I'm sorry. Don't call me sweetheart. I'm not your sweetheart. I am not your honey, and I'm not your boo. My name is Tabitha. Thank you very much. class, but at least I'm really good at what I do.
Morgan McMichaels there looking like a Karen if ever I saw one. Thank you, Morgan, for doing Tabitha all the way from Australia. And as if we'd want to do something from Australia, it would be deal with coronavirus better, don't you think? All right, remember our donations. We're going to be giving you an update in 5 minutes' time from the donations. So get your donations in. You can donate at www.hiv.scot/donate. On PayPal, paypal.me/HIV Scotland, or you can text 5HIV, 10HIV, or 20HIV to 70085. If you've already donated or you feel like you can't donate, and we know it's tough times, please do hit the share button wherever you're watching this. Every share could be worth up to £10 for our charity. So thank you so much for sharing and supporting HIV Scotland. Next up, it's another voice. We brought you powerhouse vocals. Please welcome back to HIV Scotland Live in Lockdown 2, the wonderful Sadie Sinner.
The days were long and the nights were cold. The pages turned and the tale unfolds. He left me for another lady. She stood so tall and she never slept. There was not one moment he would regret. He left me for another lady. He took my hand one day and told me he was leaving. Me disbelieving, and I had to let him go. Her name was New York, New York, and she took his heart away from my. Her name was New York, New York. She had boys in his sweet mind. The wolves, they howl for my lost soul. I fell down a deep, dark hole. He left me for another lady. She poured the drinks and she poured the powder. Diamond girl, she could talk for hours. He left me for another lady, yeah. And now I am on my own. He told me he was leaving. Me disbelieving, and I had to let him go. Her name was New York, New York, and she took his heart away from mine. Her name was New York, New York. She had boys in his sweet mind. The greatest times, I don't want to hear it. You knew that's a lie. I don't want to hear it. The new friend she introduced you to. I don't want to know them. I just want to be with you. Please don't make me guilty. New York, New York. She took his heart away from mine. Her name was New York, New York. She had boys in his sweet mind. Her name was New York, New York.
Oh, well, thank you so much, Sadie Sinner. That was an amazing song. And the best bit about those powerhouse vocals is there's no chance of us getting a copyright strike on Facebook or YouTube. Now, we thankfully have lots of these fabulous songs that are no chance of getting us copyright stricken for the next hour or so. And I can confirm that we've reached £350 in donations. So thank you so much. Over 2 hours, £350. These are the ways you can donate if you feel like you can. Please dig deep. Now, I don't think I've mentioned it for a while, but it is my 30th birthday on Monday, and that's why I'm so delighted that so many of my good friends are here tonight to sing and perform as part of my birthday. And I am having a drink, so I hope you are too. Next up, we have the wonderful singer, Rosie Singh. So please get clapping, whooping, holler, cheering, and stamping your feet. And welcome to the stage that is the internet, Rosie Sings.
Fade in on a girl with a hunger for fame, with a face and a name to remember. The past fades away because as of this day, Adele's gone, bitches. Yes, she's moving on. Her smile and your fantasies play a duet that'll make you forget where you are. The music starts playing. It's the beat of my heart saying, let me be your star. Well, hello. Can't you see me lit up on the stage as the cameras adore me? Can't you see me out walking red carpets or doing TV? Oh yes, can't you hear all my millions of fans screaming desperately for me? I'm a diva, a goddess, a star on the brink, a house-rocking vision, and I'm gonna sing a party, a riot, the whole kitchen sink. It's time for the world to find out, don't you think? Oh, look at me, can't you see? I'm fucking fabulous, baby. Feast your eyes, can't disguise my star quality. So laugh all you want, I won't be denied. What I have got is too hot to hide. I am fabulous, baby, so damn fabulous, baby. I'll be fabulous, guaranteed. I'll be fabulous, baby, fresh, free, fabulous, baby, fine and fabulous. Wait and see. Well, hello everybody, good evening. I am Rosie Sings, self-proclaimed princess, known for having the voice of an angel and the mouth of a sailor. I want to thank everybody for having me. Have a wonderful evening with this wonderful lineup. If you don't know this next song, it's because you are too young or simply not cool enough to be in my presence. Sing along, have a wonderful night, have a wonderful weekend, and try your best to enjoy the rest of COVID.
There used to be a grain tower alone on the sea. You became the light on the dark side of me. Love remains a drug that's the high, not the pill. Did you know when it snows, my eyes become large and the light that you shine can be seen? Baby, I'll compare you to a kiss from a rose on a gray. The more I get of you, the stranger it feels, yeah. Now that your rose is in bloom, the light hits the moon on the gray. Ooh, ooh. There is so much a man can tell me, so much he can say. You
remain. My power, my pleasure, my pain, baby. To me, you're like a grown addiction that I can't deny. Won't you tell me, is that healthy, babe? Did you know when it snows, my eyes become large and the light that you shine can be seen? Baby, I compare you to a kiss from a rose on a gray. The more I get of you, the stranger it feels, yay. Now that your rose is in bloom, light hits the moon on the gray.
Welcome back. As the geese are flying over my Edinburgh City Centre studio, thank you very much, Rosie Sings. Now, coming up very shortly, we have the wonderful Lady Bushra, Romeo and Jada in a wonderful performance of Marital Bliss. We have Panty Bliss, talking of bliss, Panty Bliss and Bunny O'Hare, Jojo Sutherland, Tom Urey, to name but a few. But next, I need you to pick up your glass of wine or gin. We're going to sit back and be guided through a wonderful meditation. If you saw Reuben K do his piece last time, you'll know just how funny this is. So pick up a large glass of wine and give it up for the wonderful Reuben K.
If girls say daddy all the time in porn, why do guys get weird every time I start shouting mum? Hi! Welcome. As Nancy Clinch drunkenly mumbled into her own tits, my name is Reuben K. Actress, model, and international house of pancakes. The only man who goes to the sperm bank to make a withdrawal. And the only Norman Bates impersonator to really get the wig right. And may I once more say what a joy it is to be working with so many luminaries of the industry tonight without the exhaustive experience of having to be in the same room as them all. Oh, oh God, that's missing something, isn't it? So welcome. Are you dehydrated from all the crying? Global pandemic left you feeling a little down? Well, you're in the perfect place. Tonight, for the next 5 minutes, although it'll feel longer, welcome to Unwind, the guided meditation for the end of the world. The only guided meditation with a wine pairing. Consider this your weekly attendance at church. There's ritual, prayer, we've all spent a lot of time on our knees, and there's a hungry, insecure egomaniac at the center of it who may or may not be real. Spoiler alert, it's me. Well, 2020 is still going despite public demand, but the tide is slowly turning as out of the Black Lives Matter protests, we see the glimmer of actual change on the horizon. People have changed their stock response of crazy times we're in, or it's like we're in a movie, to this is an exciting time. Cities and states in America are listening, even if the main man in charge of the country continues to treat his Twitter account like Nero's fiddle. Which begs the question, does anyone else smell smoke? Or have I just run out of lube? Spoiler alert, it's both. Since we began these guided meditations / healing sessions / blatant cries into the void, I've become somewhat of an online celebrity. In fact, I've been asked to become a spokesperson for Guide Dogs Australia, which combines my two favourite things, Labradors and men who won't look at me. Tonight's wine is vodka, because wine isn't cutting it anymore, and I need something that could strip the paint off a Cadillac, because my guts are optional at this point. It's the only thing that fills the gaping, sucking hole inside me. It's so big that a small German family from Dusseldorf have moved in and are setting up an artisan bakery, which is great, because they're finally making a profit from all my surplus yeast. Welcome to Glutentag. It's not just a charming little vodka you could serve with crudités at a casual gathering. You could also snake a drain with it, or carpet bomb Yemen. Fun! Who needs tonsils? So, let's get down to business and begin the meditation. Or, in the words of Mother Teresa, not in the face! It's time to breathe. Breathe in and breathe out. And as you do, feel the breath warm and fill you. And now we look back on the week. We're going to take the week's stresses and release them from our sphere. It's the way I've managed to monetize avoidance. But if I'm admitting it, how am I avoiding it? There's a reason I'm single. So take the week that's been. It's not great in it, is it? But in moments like this, I remember the words my mother said at my birth. Where's the ashtray? Let's start off lightly, shall we? White gay men on Grindr are offering gay men of colour their respect, support, and more importantly, their white mouths. Messages of, I see you, I support you, and I am listening, and I'm so sorry about what's going on right now, are being followed swiftly by, during these times, I feel like I should come over and give you whatever you want sexually. Please use my white mouth. That's right. Apology BJs to the black community are now a thing, because of course they are. White gay men on Grindr, why are you such messy, messy bitches? Only a white gay man to take the issue of systemic racism and generations of oppression, cut off its midriff, put in a pair of Daisy Dukes, make it talk in a baby voice, and try and make it sexy. It's the Halloween costume literally no one asked for, but it has its own Instagram account anyway. This is not how you help during these times, but it's also not helping. And so I say to the faux woke white dudes offering support, hope, and a mouthful of apology semen, fuck off. But also, cheers? And also, as a side note, homosexual Jews hurt too, and my address can be found in my bio. Aussie Prime Minister, unwind favourite, and malignant polyp of Australian politics, Scott Morrison, has responded to the Australian arm of the Black Lives Matter protest by stating irrefutably that there was no slavery in Australia, which is about as ridiculous a statement as saying there was no slavery in Australia. If you didn't know, sorry, that's my hemorrhoid. Australia was built on the systematic eradication, massacre, indentured servitude, and intentional breeding out of its First Nations people. Add to that a lovely process called blackbirding, where hundreds of thousands of South Sea Islanders were persuaded forcefully or kidnapped to work on farms on the mainland for no wages for white owners. After an expected backlash, Morrison has clarified his comments by allowing experts to admit that the conditions were slave-like and that the Indigenous workers were treated like slaves by the amazing people who owned them. Which is an incredible feat to say the word slave and owner so many times while trying desperately not to say slavery. It wasn't slavery, just very much like it. So much like it that it was in fact slavery. It's like seeing a house on fire and saying, that's not a fire, it's mostly house. Scott Morrison, you are the leader of a country with a dark history and a huge responsibility. You need to impose drastic police reform, pay compensation and rent, and there needs to be protection on land rights given over. But this is being aired in Scotland, and I know you won't hear it, because you have not just broken records, but also physics, by having your head shoved not just in the sand, but up your own ass as well. Breathe in and fuck off. And breathe out. And as you breathe out, allow the hate and sadness to leave your body. Watch it walk out the door like every other man I've trusted. And now that you're just a husk, allow me to do what I allowed the Croatian rugby team to do to me last summer. Fill you with goodness. I'm not saying I'm a slut, but last week I was mistaken for a bruised profiterole. Don't you feel better? If you do, my name is Reuben Kay. And if not, my name is Nancy Clench. Thank you, and good night. Oh, if I had a gag reflex, that'd be painful. All right, are you no, don't use this, don't use the oil base. You'll ruin the carpet. Excuse me.
Breathe in and fuck off. I was hearing, because I can't hear any of our performers tonight, but I know they are fabulous because I watched most of the videos, but I didn't sit through Ruben's, and apparently it's a joke about me. I hope it was a funny one, but breathe in. Fuck off. That's what better a performance from someone like Reuben Kay, an absolute international legend. Now, next up, I've been reading the comments, I've been seeing the Instagram posts. You're a nippy bunch, aren't you? But she's here. She's here. Please put your hands together for the wonderful Lady Bushra.
When I got you next to me,
all night I'm riding with you. I know you got my back, and you know I got you. So come on, come on, come on. Let's get physical. Lights out, follow the noise. Baby, keep on dancing like you ain't got a choice. So come on, come on, come on. Let's get physical.
Thank you, Lady Bushra. Whew! I am getting my steps in and my muscles pumped, whatever is left of them. Thank you so much, Lady Bushra, for being part of HV Scotland live in lockdown. Next up is a good friend of mine. He regularly performs at the Stand Comedy Club here in Edinburgh, which happens to be just over the road. Please put your hands together. We're going to go for a little walk with him now, the wonderful Gareth Much.
Very well informed, to be fair. We definitely didn't teach me it in school. They taught me nothing in school. My school was a joke, though, to be fair. Like, we didn't even teach sex education in school. The whole way that we found out who was gay and who was straight in high school was we'd ask them how they looked at their nails. And if you did that, that would mean you were gay. Huh? And the straight answer was if you did that. Which I never understood, because that looks like you're holding a dick, doesn't it? Going mad on a dick. But no. And that looks like you're refusing, doesn't it? Going, no, thank you. Put your dick away, Neil. Thank you, but no thanks. I'm full, mate. I'm full. But no, I don't know a lot about it. But what I do know, the little I do know, is that we need to end the stigma. My name is Gar. I was named after a Welsh rugby legend, and there's another Welsh rugby legend called Gareth Thomas. And I know he has HIV, and I know he's working very hard to also kill the stigma and normalise HIV. So if I can be any part in helping that message, I happily subscribe to it. Thank you very much for having me. I haven't got much. Enjoy the rest of your lives. Cheers. Kill the fucking stigma. I am honestly out of breath. Bad this. Bad. Have I been holding up a car this whole time? Shit, I have. Fucking follow me on Twitter. That'll be the best follower I've had. Get subscribed to the YouTube channel as well. All right, all the best. Bye-bye.
Clip of his. Oh, it was done. Blimmin' hell. Thank you for your little birthday message, Gareth. I was sat there having a drink. I wanted to have nice time. Little put my feet up. But thank you, Gareth, for that. I loved your little walk in the park. And I also, because I remember that from school, when you couldn't tell if someone was gay, but people, all the bullies, thought you could tell if someone was gay by the way that their hands were. Now, the next performer we have is a superstar. Morgan McMichaels absolutely loved her the last time, and I know that you're going to really love this poignant number. Please put your hands together for the one and only Mystica Glamour.
I'm sorry, but I don't want to be an emperor. That's not my business. I don't want to rule or conquer anyone. I should like to help everyone if possible. Jew, Gentile, black man, white. We all want to help one another. Human beings are like that. We want to live by each other's happiness, not by each other's misery. We don't want to hate and despise one another. In this world, there's room for everyone, and the good earth is rich and can provide for everyone. The way of life can be free and beautiful, but we have lost the way. Greed has poisoned men's souls, has barricaded the world with hate, has goose-stepped us into misery and bloodshed. We have developed speed, but we have shut ourselves in. Machinery that gives abundance has left us in want. Our knowledge has made us cynical, our cleverness hard and unkind. We think too much and feel too little. More than machinery, we need humanity. More than cleverness, we need kindness and gentleness. Without these qualities, life will be violent, and all will be lost. The aeroplane and the radio have brought us closer together. The very nature of these inventions cries out for the goodness in men, cries out for universal brotherhood, for the unity of us all. Even now, my voice is reaching millions throughout the world, millions of despairing men, women, and little children, victims of a system that makes men torture and imprison innocent people. To those who can hear me, I say, do not despair. The misery that is now upon us is but the passing of greed, the bitterness of men who fear the way of human progress. The hate of men will pass, and dictators die, and the power they took from the people will return to the people. And so long as men die, liberty will never perish. Soldiers, don't give yourselves to brutes, men who despise you, enslave you, who regiment your lives, tell you what to do, what to think, or what to feel, who drill you, diet you, treat you like cattle, use you as cannon fodder. Don't give yourselves to these unnatural men, machine men,
with machine minds and machine hearts. You are not machines. You are not cattle. You are men. You have the love of humanity in your hearts. You don't hate. Only the unloved hate. The unloved and the unnatural. Soldiers, don't fight for slavery. Fight for liberty. In the 17th chapter of St. Luke it is written, the kingdom of God is within man. Not one man nor a group of men, but in all men, in you. You, the people, have the power. The power to create machines. The power to create happiness. You, the people, have the power to make this life free and beautiful. To make this life a wonderful adventure. Then in the name of democracy, let us use that power. Let us all unite. Let us fight for a new world. A decent world. That will give men a chance to work, that will give youth a future, and old age a security. By the promise of these things, brutes have risen to power. But they lie. They do not fulfill that promise. They never will. Dictators free themselves, but they enslave the people. Now let us fight to fulfill that promise. Let us fight to free the world, to do away with national barriers, to do away with greed, with hate and intolerance. Let us fight for a world of reason. A world where science and progress will lead to all men's happiness. Soldiers, in the name of democracy, let us all unite!
Mystica Glamour, everyone, with another fabulous performance. Thank you so much, Mystica, for being part of this wonderful show. Next up, we have a reigning legend. We promised you stars, and we are giving you stars. This person won RuPaul's Drag Race Season 12 in... She's here. In very strange circumstances. A live video link final. But she's here by live video link too. She's going to be performing from her own living room. Please put your hands together for the one and only Jada Essence Hall!
Yeah.
Essence Hall, everyone. Give it up for the Queen, the reigning champion of RuPaul's Drag Race. Thank you so much for being with us in our living rooms from yours. Next up, we have a duo, a new duet for you. We have, it's, now I don't know if it's Marital Bliss or Martial Bliss. It's one of them anyway. Something is blissful. Please put your hands together for Jada Love and Romeo De La Cruz.
It couldn't happen. It wouldn't happen. But for the sake of illustrating some constructive and destructive ways of handling marital conflicts, let's suppose that there's an argument going on at the Adams house, and that there's an identical argument going on at the same time over at the Kane's. Let's listen in on both couples for a moment. First, the Kane's.
It's only money. Let's just throw it all away.
It's only a budget. It's not sacred.
Not with you around.
Me? Who does all the scraping and scrounging to keep us on that precious budget? I suppose it was you who shopped in 4 different grocery stores.
What can I do for you, sir?
I want a lipstick. You heard me.
Oh, yes, sir. What shade?
Any color as long as it's red.
Well, we have a vast assortment of shades.
I take pepper red.
Oh, yes, ma'am. Anything else?
What new face powders you got?
Well, we have been selling a lot of this Andre number 3.
I take a box. And one of these combs. And a card of bobby pins. And a bottle of this hand lotion. And mascara. A jar of cold cream and some cigarettes.
Yes, ma'am.
You sure you don't want something for after dinner?
Don't strain your wallet. I pay for it.
Oh, forget about it. Figured as a little coming out present.
After a year in that birdcage, I don't feel like wisecracking about it.
And over at the Adams house.
You don't realize it, but I shop in 4 different grocery stores today just to save a penny here, a penny there, and a dime somewhere else.
You figure I don't know why you spend so much time on the food part of it? I mean, you figure whatever you save there is yours.
Oh, yes! I am very underhanded. Sure, I scrimp on the groceries just so I can have some money of my own. 2 or 3 whole dollars a month. But you have a big fat allowance filled right in the
bucket. Oh, boy, let's
play. The Adamses and the Canes are at it again. The gist of their argument so similar that in switching from one house to the other, not a thread is lost. Now, the best way to handle a disagreement is through calm discussion. But as you can see, neither the Adamses nor the Canes are using the best way right now.
And I say either.
I say neither.
And I say neither.
Either.
Either.
Neither.
Neither. Let's call the whole thing off.
I like potato.
And I like potato.
I like tomato.
And I like tomato.
Potato.
Potato.
Tomato.
Tomato.
Let's call the whole thing off. I'm butto. If we call the whole thing off, then we must part.
And oh, if we ever part, then that might break my heart.
So if I like pajamas and you like pajama,
I'll wear pajamas and give up pajamas. For we know we need each other, so we
better call a calling off.
Oh, let's call the whole mess out.
I say house.
And I say house.
I say mouse.
And I say mouse.
House.
House.
Mouse.
Mouse.
Let's call the whole thing off. Oh, I like vanilla.
And I like vanilla.
I sarsaparilla.
And I sarsaparilla.
Vanilla.
Vanilla.
Chocolate.
Strawberry.
Apricot.
Gagoozes.
But oh, if we call the whole thing off, then we must part.
And oh, if we ever part, then that might break my heart.
Now if you go for oysters and I go for oysters,
why, I'll order oysters and cancel the oysters. For we know we need each other, so we
better call a calling off, oh, babe.
Oh, let's call the whole thing off.
Let's call.
will have conflicts with your marriage partner. With two individuals, two points of view, it would be impossible not to disagree sometimes, and unrealistic not to learn how to handle marital conflicts. Learning the techniques now is better than learning them later the hard way.
Jada Love and Romeo De La Cruz, thank you so much for being part of HIV Scotland live in lockdown with that one, Marshall Bliss. I do have to give a couple of shout outs. Jamie Oliver Devlin is looking for just a couple more likes so that he can double his £20 donation to £40. Go and check out the thread on Facebook. And Michael Jenkins, the voice of UB40, thank you so much for watching. I hope you'll now turn this shout out into a donation. And if you are watching, here are all the ways you can donate. You can head over to www.hiv.scot/donate. You can donate on PayPal, paypal.me/HIV Scotland, or you can text 5HIV, 10HIV, or 20HIV to 70085 if you want to donate 5, 10, or 20 pounds. If you are texting, you can add no info to your message to opt out of any of HIV Scotland's marketing text messages. But as far as I'm aware, I've never had a marketing message from HIV Scotland and I never opted out. So what have you got to lose? Just text 5HIV, 10HIV, or 20HIV now. And we have an amazing couple of acts for you next. We've got a lovely little clip from a comedian, Dana Alexander, and then we'll be going straight in to some more backstage shenanigans from Panty Bliss and Bunny O'Hare. So please give it up for Dana Alexander.
Happy birthday, Nathan. Thank you for, it's Dana Alexander all the way in London, trying not to die, trying to stay skinty enough for my coffin. It is your 30th birthday. 30, those were the days. That was the year I found my first gray pubic hair. Ah, those are the times. Anyways, thank you guys for coming together for this really special event, raising money for HIV Scotland. Make sure you get that information at hiv.scot, hiv.scot. Make sure you find out how to get tested, where to get tested, and information that affects people in the community socially, economically, on the basis of education. Anyways, happy birthday, you guys, and happy Pride, everybody. Bye.
Life is boring me to tears after all these years. No sunshine, no moonlight, no stardust, no sign of romance. We don't stay. But he turned out to be like every other man I love. I love.
Shanti Bliss and Bunny O'Hare, everyone. Thank you for joining us all the way from Dublin. And I managed to introduce you, Bunny, for the first time, because last time I got told off in the comments for saying Panty Bliss, and Bunny O'Hare was there beside you. Next up, we have one of Fife's original divas. Please put your hands together, singing the wonderful song New Emotion from TTF. Please put your hands together for Gladys Allcock. Thank you, Gladys. I seen you in the comments blaming our tech for your audio being slightly off, and I think your lip sync was just slightly off. I'm only kidding. You know these things when you send videos through multiple people. Next up, actually, before we go to next, I wanted to tell you about how to donate. If you've just joined us on Facebook, YouTube, or Twitter, funnily enough, Twitter has been the feed that's been on all the way through. So if you are looking for a stable feed, go to Twitter, because they're not copyright striking anything. You can donate at hv.scot/donate, paypal.me/hvscotland, or if you're on your phone right now, switch over to Messenger and text 5HIV, 10HIV, or 20HIV to 70085 to donate 5, 10, or 20 pounds. Next up, we've got my good friend. She's been working with HIV Scotland to bring some fabulous comedy into the well-being of people living with HIV. So we're going to hear a little bit, and I think we get to see Jojo's knickers. So we're going to see Jojo Sutherland, and then we're going to go straight into an excerpt from Martin Belk's play, Pretty Broken Punk. So I'm going to say just now, give it up for the wonderful Jojo Sutherland.
Ooh, what's that sound? It's the little birdies telling me it's someone's birthday. Happy birthday to Nathan. Hello everybody, HIV Scotland. Hope you're all having a fabulous night. Just popped in to say happy birthday to Nathan. I don't have your present, I'm really sorry, because, well, I can't get to see you. So I racked my brains, I thought, oh, what can I give him? And I thought, oh, what he really wants is to see my underwear on the line. Yeah, me bras and knickers. Don't say I'm not good to you. You can't have them, they're mine. Have a happy birthday. Bye.
Hello, live in lockdown. I'm Martin Belk, expat New Yorker and honorary Scot. I host LateSupperPodcast.com. Tonight, I'm delighted to support HIV Scotland with Daniel Check Lucas performing an excerpt from my forthcoming stage play, Pretty Broken Punks, Lipstick, Leather Jeans, A Death of New York, dedicated to our friend Larry Kramer.
In the 80s, all the broken people came to New York. This was before all that corporate bullshit now. It was mom, pop, and all the trimmings. Old school. It's like the Harlem drag diva Dorian Corey once said, the old school is concerned with what you can create. The new school is distracted by what you can acquire. Doesn't matter. We're all for sale now. In the summer of 1987, I was immersed, deep in Vogue uptown, deep in Dick downtown. My daddy was working at Calvin Klein, and I found a city I could get lost in. I went from Hayseed to Hot Twink in one night. All the critics love you in New York. The massive buildings gleamed with possibility. Everybody looked like dancers in a great ballet. It was June, and it was hot. Taxi! Perry Street. To meet up with my new friend, Marty Lipton. He worked at a hair salon. Now, Marty was sexy. He had muscles, but not too much. And long, black New York hair all combed back to look like John Travolta. And the best part, he was nice to me. This awkward, out-of-place Southern kid from the other side of East Jesus. And Marty knew that I liked him, but nothing ever happened, and nothing was ever gonna happen. Marty showed me the town. And something that I've learned, when the world turns your way and somebody likes you, you better make sure you enjoy it, because sometimes it goes fast. It'll get away from you before you know it. A year later, June, and I was lost in a swarm of people near Christopher Street for another massive gay pride parade, and I glimpsed Marty standing back behind the crowds, watching it all. And I almost passed him right by, not recognizing him on account of half his face turned purple from Kaposi's sarcoma. He waved, he called my name, and he locked eyes dead on, begging me not to take notice of the skin cancer. And I still feel awful about it. You see, me and mine, we were all supposed to be dead by the time we turned 30. The message of our youth? Living on borrowed time. Now, somehow, I made it unscathed, physically, anyway. And ever since seeing Marty Lipton and legions of others slinking in doorways, ashamed to show their faces, I have been reckoning with the theft of our generation called X. The first generation to do worse than their parents. The first generation to die before their time. And no one cared about any of it. Not the fucking Reagans, the Thatchers or Bushes, or the closet case Mayor Ed Koch. A few months later, Marty got admitted to St. Vincent's Hospital, the place that 20-something kids went to die. In late September, I got the call from a friend that we should go and visit Marty. Visiting was important. Some were left all alone by their families on account of Jesus, so you visited out of compassion and as a big fuck you. We found Marty in his room, sitting up, being chipper. His window overlooked the very doorway where I saw him at the parade. Now, I was the youngest, and I scuttled around the bed and found me a hiding spot. I listened, they chatted. Now, part of the head fuck was that Marty was still young and sexy. Dying people aren't supposed to be young and sexy, no? Yeah. After a while, he turned to me and asked me how I was doing. I'll never forget feeling stunned. And what are you supposed to say? Yeah, everything's great. How about you? And then he reached for this white styrofoam cooler he had by the side of his bed, and he opened it and said with a smile, as if we were all at a picnic in Central Park, "Hey, want some ice cream?" Now, I didn't know then, and I'm still not sure. How do you take a dying man's ice cream?
Thank you very much to Daniel Check Jones as well for reading that piece from Martin Belk's play, Pretty Broken Punks, about life in New York City. Next up, we have a voice of Glasgow. He has been described as Mother Glasgow himself. Please put your hands together for the one and only Tom Urey.
Hello, and thank you, Nancy. I'm delighted to be back. Had a great time last time. This time I thought I would do something really quite meaningful and quite serious. And then I thought, fuck it, I'll just do Xanadu. Join in, I'm putting the words up on the screen.
A place where nobody dared to go. The love that we came to know, they call it Xanadu. Open your eyes and see what we have made is real. We are in Xanadu. A million lights are dancing, and there you are, a shooting star. An everlasting world, and you're here with me eternally. Xanadu, in Xanadu. Xanadu, Xanadu, in Xanadu. Xanadu, your neon lights will shine for you, Xanadu. The love, the echoes of long ago, you needed the world to know, they are in Xanadu. that came through a million years, that lived on through all the tears, it came to Xanadu. A million lights are dancing, and there you are, a shooting star, an everlasting world, and you're here with me eternally. Xanadu, Xanadu, in Xanadu. Xanadu, Xanadu, in Xanadu. Now that I'm here, now that you're near, in Xanadu. That you're near in Xanadu, Xanadu.
Oh, thank you so much, Tom Urey. That was great. And I love the effort that you go to give us the sing-along lyrics too. I'm sure you were all singing along at home as I was too. We have entered our final section of HIV Scotland Live in Lockdown. I can confirm we are at £400 raised tonight, and I'm sure you'll want to dig deep in our last half an hour to donate to HIV Scotland. And you can donate just by sharing this video feed, not just sharing the video feed, share all our content too. Go over and like HIV Scotland on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram to see everything that we do. You can also order a free HIV test to be sent to your address over at www.hivtest.scot. It's always better to know your status, and now is a perfect time to test. We've been in lockdown for over 3 months, and a window period, which is the time that a test can detect a HIV infection, is actually 3 months, so the test that we send you. That means it's perfect time now for you to know your actual HIV status, as long as you've been keeping up with the lockdown rules. And it's always better before you get a little bit frisky, which I think Nicola Sturgeon announced yesterday that you can indeed start to do with one partner from another household, only if you are a single person living alone. So make sure you check the rules before you get digging in on Grindr and having your sex parties. But who am I to talk? Next up, we have the wonderful Val Qaeda. So I hope you're going to enjoy this performance. Please clap, whoop, stamp your feet at home and make it a party atmosphere. And put your hands together for Val Qaeda.
Take a dive into my eyes. Yeah, the eyes of the lioness. Feel the power, they lie. A little look, a little touch. You know the power of silence. Yeah, keep it up, keep it up. I was looking for some high, high highs, yeah. Till I got it, does it, you? You got me pelican, fly, 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 yeah. Cause I'm way up and I ain't coming down. Keep taking me higher. Ah, yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I'm taking me higher. Ah, yeah, 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 yeah.
You got me pelican, fly, 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 yeah.
Thank you so much, Valkyda, for that Fuego number. And I could see Queenie in the comments absolutely loving it. He said it was worth £20 alone, which I think that means you've already donated £20, but maybe it's worth an extra £20, Queenie. What do you think? Get sharing, get donating. We have about half an hour left of tonight's live feed. Now, I am so thrilled to introduce the next act. She is a Brighton drag queen, a staple of UK's drag scene. She's going to be fucking and Jaeger bombing and everything throughout the next 4 minutes. Please put your hands together for the one and only Miss Jason.
Ah, hello up there, my lovelies from Scotland. This is this tired old tart down on the south coast, just checking in to say hi. I was so grateful when Nancy asked me to be part of this. I'm just watching, I'm knocking the mirror and my picture seemed like it's swelling. I feel like I'm on a ship, feel like I'm cruising, but I'm not, dears. Oh, fucking hell, I wish I was. But anyway, darlings, I hope you're all well. And it's lovely to be part of this. And this lockdown time's fucking awful, isn't it? But there is some good news for me. The muscles in my right arm are coming up lovely. If I ever play tennis, I shall shoot the ball right across the court. Anyway, darlings, I hope you're all right. I'm having a little drink here. I'll have a little Jägerbomb with all of you. All I have been doing during this crisis is fucking drinking and wanking, to be honest, but don't tell anybody. Anyway, boys and girls, love ya. What would I do without the booze, Jim? The booze and Pornhub. Oh, I'd be fucked otherwise. In fact, I've been watching Pornhub and I've realised I've never been fucked properly yet in my life, and I'm 52. I don't suppose it'll happen yet. Or ever, of course, unless there's any offers from Scotland. Darlings, it's lovely to be with you. I think that we've all gone into this and we're going to come out to a very, very different world, because it's a time of thought and reflection. But what we must do is we must always, I'm not going to say fight, because I don't like the word fight. We must always face prejudice wherever it exists. And as a HIV positive man, I've had to do that several times. And some, you know, people even within our own community are not as supportive as they should be of people that are HIV positive. But anyway, my darlings, I'm going to dedicate this song to all of you, and then I'm going to have another Jägerbomb. I don't know if I can work this fucking thing. Thanks, Nancy, for being so patient. I've been a fucking nuisance to poor Miss Clench. There you are. But where the fuck? Oh, there it is. Boys and girls, I hope it's loud enough. Look after yourselves. Take care. And see you soon. I see she's a green. Red roses too, I've seen them bloom for me and for you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, warm summer's day and a cold winter's night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow sit pretty in the sky, reflected in the faces of those children passing by, friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? But they're really saying, I love you. I hear children play and watch them grow They seem to know more than we'll ever know. But I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Oh yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world. And remember, my darling, you are some of the people that make the world wonderful. And the fucking iPad's playing on now. I'll chuck it down there. Look, I can't turn the fucker off. Anyway, look after yourselves. Sarah's going to end up on a lovely note there when I'm in my... Love you all. Bye.
The lovely Miss Jason, thank you so much for being part of our live feed. She was the one I had to get her arm round the back, not to say yes, but just to bloody get the thing recorded. Thank you, Miss Jason. And I so love that as a HIV positive man yourself, that you are helping challenge the stigma just by being open about your status. And I know that many people can't be open about their status. So the fact that you can and you are a warrior in the fight against HIV stigma, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. We only have 5 more performers left of this evening. We will be finished just about after 11:30. Can you imagine? Last time I thought we'd be finished by 12 and we were still going on till 1:30. Can you believe I've managed to organise a show? Oh, who thought? Next up, we have the wonderful Tairis Mongari.
Fuck off, fuck off, fuck off, fuck off! Get out! Get out! Idiots!
Fuck off, you fat, useless sack of fucking Yankee, danky, doodle, shite. Fuck off, will you please, yeah?
Fine dining!
No, chef.
A fine fucking mess!
You're about as fucking consistent as pigeon shit on Trafalgar Square.
Chef Ramsay lost it and just went like, Satan on my ass.
That wouldn't even pass as fucking kitty cat fucking cat food!
Just take one good look at yourselves in the mirror. Because it's a fucking disgrace.
Yeah. Katy Perry. Miko.
Isn't all that you want, boy? All that you can have, boy? Got me spread like a buffet. Bon appetit, baby. Appetite for seduction. Fresh out the oven. Melting your mouth, kind of loving. Bon appetit, baby. I'm a 5-star Michelin. I call me a phone in. You want what I'm cooking? Boy, let me take you
under candlelight. We can wine and dine. A table for two.
And it's okay
if you take your time. Eat with your hands fine. I'm on the menu.
Who wants to eat some carpet?
I'll eat a bit of carpet.
Bike. Yeah, bike.
It'll be far too stiff. They'll get it in the piping bag and they won't get it out.
Very small. Where did the rest of the mix go?
Dinky. The only thing that's wrong is the size.
Okay, whoa, Holiday. Wait, hold on, Holiday. You can't give it to them dry like that. You gotta get that shit wet first, nigga. Like, come on now. You gotta prep them for shit like that. They can't just get that shit right off the top. Like, you gotta bring that shit back. Bring that shit the fuck back.
Let's go!
As the host, it's up to Peter to read out the results.
So let's see who's won.
In fourth place is Mickey.
Oh!
Why are you trying to get ahead of me?
You won, Jane.
Oh, my God.
Enjoy the money. I hope it makes you very happy. Dear Lord, what a sad little life, Jane. You ruined my night completely so you could have the money, but I hope now you spend it on getting some lessons in grace and decorum, because you have all the grace of a reversing dump truck without any tyres on. So Jane, take your money and get off my property.
Oh,
Lunch Lady Selects.
School cafeteria food you can eat at home. From freezer to table to toilet in record time.
Just heat and eat, babies.
And now Lunch Lady Selects comes in all your favorite school cafeteria flavors. Tina, Sparkle, show them today's specials.
Sloppy hooves.
Monkey nuggets.
Mac and sneeze.
Some kind of wet meat.
It's like you never left school.
If you're missing the meals that make you grow, Lady Selects school food at home.
Winner of the Great British Bake Off 2016 is
Taylor Spongardi.
Taylor Mongardi, everyone, give it up for that epic view around Gordon Ramsay. Come dine with me. Oh, so bloody good. Thank you so much for being part of HMV Scotland Live in lockdown. Now, you do have four acts left. You can donate during those four acts. I've seen that Jamie is trying to get you to share. I'm sure I've seen at least 30 shares since he asked over Twitter, Facebook and YouTube. So I think it's time for him to cough up with his promise of £100. Don't you, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and those beyond gender norms. Next up, we have a fucking powerhouse of a comedian. She is all the way in South Carolina. And I'd like you to put it up for the one and only Hayley Boyle.
Hi, I'm American comedian, single mom, and tie-dye enthusiast Hayley Boyle. And I first off want to wish Nancy Clinch the happiest of birthdays. I love you so much, boo. Now, if you don't know me, I'm one of these, like, super butch cishet women. Everybody thinks I'm a lesbian, but I'm not even a tiny bit lesbian. Or maybe I am, because I got to tell you, the first time I met Nancy, I was like, damn, girl, wash your face and you can stay in my room. There's something special about you, boo. Now listen, there's nothing sexier than knowing your HIV status. And as a mom, I know how important it is. Because if you're pregnant and you're HIV positive, you can do things to stop the transmission of the virus to your baby. But you have to know your status. So get tested. An even sexier statistic is that 97% of Scots that know they have HIV have such a low viral load thanks to treatment, they can't transmit it to anybody else. Oh yes, that's right. It's a dickstravaganza again. We don't have to live in fear. Now listen, speaking of dick, I'm a bit of a connoisseur. Your present for me, Nancy, is a couple of vintage dick jokes, okay? These are from the very beginning. You're going, step into my time machine. I was riding New York subway one day when a man struck up a conversation with me. And at first it was just normal stuff like, oh, I like your iPod, or is that urine I smell? Oh, great. It's New York subway stuff. Totally regular. Super cosmopolitan. I'm losing my train of thought. I'm sorry. The baby's in the other room making noise. Oh my gosh. Never have babies. They are so cute, but then they grow up into these little monsters that walk and destroy everything and eat all of your candy. Okay. It's super annoying. Plus, he's always trying to touch my tits. It's distracting. Anyway, we're having this normal conversation and out of the blue, this man turns to me and says, you know what? No woman has ever been able to make me come with her mouth. Okay, sir. I don't know why you're telling me that. You're trying to appeal to my competitive spirit? Did you think I was going to be like, oh, can I try? Really, bitch? Look at me. If you want some enthusiasm, show me a cookie. I have never understood the appeal of blowjobs. I just don't. It's weird, though, because my gay friends seem to love it. In fact, I have one friend who's a sex worker, and his whole job is just getting paid to let people suck his dick. That's incredible. I would love to have a job like that, but I don't understand why it exists. Because if I have to suck a dick, I'm usually like, oh, fine, I guess you've been good, and it is your birthday. But my gay friends, what are you guys doing? Just leaving the house like, damn, I gotta suck a dick tonight. Hell, I'll pay $20 to suck a dick tonight. It's crazy. Just get yourself a hot dog, girl. It's a lot cheaper. Now listen, I wish I could hang out with you guys all night, but I can't. Because I have a 2-year-old in the next room who's about to break this door down because this episode of Odd Bods is over. So please, have fun, have safe sex, and know your status. Because knowing is everything. Stay safe. Happy birthday!
Ah, Haley Boyle, my good friend, all the way from the States. Thank you so much for getting down with it and getting in on the party for HIV Scotland Live in lockdown. I love you so much. I cannot wait till you're back here in Scotland. Now, the next act is our headline act. You've seen nothing until you've seen our next act. I'm so incredibly delighted, humbled. What other adjectives could I use? I am honoured. I am feeling very grateful to be in this moment with you all, sharing this exclusive moment for this next act. She is the powerhouse vocals. She is Scotland's biggest drag queen, literally. Please put your hands together for the one and only, Nancy Clench.
Another week, another day, when I call your miles away, in the arms of another. All my friends say I'm crazy, night after night I'm waiting. Say that I'm wrong, then you tell me I'm coming on too strong. One step at a time, one reason to put this love on the line. You can believe it's true without a door. Now I'm one step at a time. When I sleep, I dream of you. You're in my mind and everything I do. Well, I still don't feel that it's over. I know what's right could be with you, holding you tight. Now that you've gone, won't you tell me where I've been going wrong? One step at a time, one reason to put this love on the line. Can't believe it's true. Now I'm one step at a time. Another week, another day, when I call your miles away. Daddy, now you're still, it's over. One step at a time, one step at a time. One step at a time, one reason to put this love on the line. Can't believe it's true. Now I'm one step at a time, 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 one step at a time.
Oh, aren't you as humbled as I? What I think is hilarious is that I have the eye patch and the same dress. I could have just recorded that now, but I thought, no, I'll record it last week in the same clothes. But you know me, never change. All right, we've got two more acts to go, so you've got two performances to get your donations in. You know how to donate. Get texting, because that's the best way, I think, to donate. Next up, we have a lovely drag queen. She looks like Marilyn Monroe, but she definitely doesn't smell or act like her. Please put your hands together for the one and only Sherry Bomb.
Me, Cherry Bomb, thanks for tuning in. Almost ready for launch. They're just running some final diagnostics to make sure my makeup is 100% sickening. So, see you in space!
Yeah. past 100,000 miles. I'm feeling very still, and I think my spaceship knows which way to go. Tell my husband I love him very much.
He knows.
Ground control to cherry bomb. The circuit's gone. There's something wrong. Can you hear me, cherry bomb? Can you hear me, cherry bomb? Can you hear me, cherry bomb? Can you hear me? Here I am, floating in the tent. Above the world. Planet Earth is blue, and there's nothing I can do.
Cherry bomb, ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, and those who do not conform to gender norms. Can you believe it? We have made it to the end of the show. We have one final act for you, and then we've got a couple of goodbye messages. I'm so grateful to all of you who have watched the show throughout the evening, who have shared it. There's one stream that is the full 3.5-4 hours on Twitter. So if you want to share this video tomorrow, then go over to Twitter and ask everyone to watch it back. You'll also get to see the videos on YouTube and Facebook, and we will be posting up over the next week some of the highlights, certainly the ones that don't give us a copyright strike anyway. Thank you so much for watching. This last song, did I mention it was my birthday on Monday? I am turning 30. Can you believe me, Nancy Clench, a woman who looks like 45, turning 30, but that is indeed the case. So tonight I'm off to drink lots of wine because the weekend has only just begun. I've not even drank half a bottle of vodka. Can you believe it? But I am going to get drunk. Now, this song is from one of my best friends. She doesn't shy away from controversy. I've kicked her in the teeth before a few times, but she is singing one of my favourite songs, one of the songs that I love to sing with her at the Phoenix Arts Club. Please put your hands together for this, our final performance, the one and only Vanity Von Glow.
Thank you, Nancy. I wish I could be with you in Edinburgh, but obviously I can't stand you. So instead, I am thinking of Scotland and of all the great work that you guys at HIV Scotland are doing. And so I'm going to sing a song that reminds me of being home. The sun shines bright on Loch Lomond. 'Twas me and my true love spent many happy days on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Lomond. We will take the high road and I'll take the low road, and I'll be in Scotland before you, where me and my true love will never meet again on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Lomond. 'Twas there that we parted in yon shady glen on the steep, steep of the Lomond, where purple in hue the Highland hills refuse,
back in spring. Though the woeful may cease from their greeting, oh, you'll take the high road, and I'll take the low road, and I'll be in Scotland before you. But me and my true love will never meet again.
Thank you so much, Vanity Von Glow, for bringing our evening of entertainment, over 3.5 hours, over 45 acts, to a close. Now, before I finish, I seem to have left one massive, massive fact out of the whole evening, because I've been talking about my 30th birthday, which is indeed on Monday, but I know someone else who has their birthday coming up very, very shortly as well. On Monday, someone by the name of Jenny Sparling, who happened to 30 years ago push a very, very handsome boy out of herself. She is, some would say, the Clench's mother, Madame Clench herself. Happy birthday when it comes, Jenny. And I thought we'd end this evening with a little rendition of Happy Birthday. Here we go. Oh, wait, I need a drink first. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Jenny, happy birthday to you. And that is all you're getting from me in terms of live vocals this evening. So we have raised over £500. Thank you for joining us tonight. It has been an absolute pleasure. If you want to find out more about HIV Scotland, head over to www.hiv.scot. You can also order a free HIV test at www.hivtest.scot. Like, share, follow us on all the social media, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. You have been an absolutely wonderful audience. I'm looking forward to reading all your comments and replying to them over the next 3 hours when I get even more drunk. Thank you. I'm going to leave you with a message from the wonderful Morgan McMichaels. Have a good night. See you later. Bye-bye.
Oh! Wow, what an amazing show. Thank you, everyone, for joining us tonight at the HIV Scotland Live in Lockdown show. A huge round of applause to all of the fantastic entertainers that worked their butts off tonight to help HIV Scotland raise funds with the Coronavirus Support Fund. You can donate to HIV Scotland at any time of the year at www.hiv.scot/donate. My name is Morgan McMichaels. We appreciate all the love and support that you have shown us. I love you, Scotland. I love you, HIV Scotland. And you know what? Remember, stay home, stay safe, and stay sane. Mwah.